Shalom, this is Rabbi David Eidensohn, author of the book Secret of the Scale, discussing how to improve our own self-image and getting along better with others. Today, in the New York Times, there are two articles of interest. One is about Darwin, for 150 years influencing the world with his ideas of natural selection, survival of the fittest. And of course, there's the Israeli elections today, and people are very concerned about the future there because of the situation with Iran. It could, God forbid, end up nuclear war. Iran has threatened to make an atomic weapon and use it on Israel. The question is, will Israel anticipate this with its own war against Iran? It is a time we pray to Hashem, we pray to God that there should be peace. What is the connection between these two articles in the New York Times, the front page, about 150 years of Darwin and the Israeli elections? In the Israeli elections, we see the great conflict that went on in the last 100, 200, maybe 300 years of Jewish life between religious Jews and secular Jews. A great battle, a great war. For the last hundreds of years, the ascendancy has been with secular Jews, and the decline was with religious Jews. So much so that after the Second World War, when the religious centers of Europe were destroyed, the dominating forces in Jewish life were secular, and the religious were just a small group, refugees. This was about 60 years ago. I grew up at that time, and in my childhood and in my youth, the early phases of my youth, religious people were just utterly denigrated and despised, and there was no place for us. People would not tolerate me walking out with a yarmulke. They said, "You don't believe that people come from monkeys, you believe in God and religion." This was unacceptable. Grown people would attack a young boy, me, attack me. How can you? I mean, verbally they would attack me because they felt sorry for me. How could you throw out your life with religion? That's the way it was then. Today it's much different. Today the religious community, the Torah community, has great power, and all of our enemies in the secular world are dissembling, collapsing, disappearing with intermarriage, or hundreds of thousands of them are returning to the fold and becoming religious. I was once in a rabbinical court, and we look out the window, and we see an apparition. Something is walking towards the rabbinical court. Can't tell exactly what it is. I went outside. I see it's a young woman, and she obviously is a newly religious person who doesn't really know how to dress when you come to rabbinic court, and so she used her imagination, some type of a medieval nunnery outfit, whatever it was. This is going on all over. Thousands and thousands of people have had enough of the secular world. I once had a discussion with a friend of mine in Muncie, and it came out that he was from the royal family of England. I said, "Wow, you're from the royal family of England?" He says, "Yeah." He says, "Muncie is full of converts, but nobody knows they're converts." From all over far and near, people are running to Muncie, to Israel, to become part of the Torah world, and the rest is just declining and collapsing. But this is a very recent phenomenon. For hundreds of years, it was the other way. There are whole families of the most religious stock where 90% disappeared from the religious world. And now everything is going in reverse, that the Torah world is really exploding and attracting Jews and non-Jews to it. The two articles we are discussing are about Darwin and about the Israeli elections. And the two articles basically reflect the great contrast between religious thought and secular thought. Now let's go to a third thing, the Islam, the Islamic world, and the Christian world, these two different worlds. The Islamic world is exploding demographically. It's growing, not only in its own countries, but the Muslims coming to Western Europe are exploding in population growth at the same time that the native stock of West Europeans are disappearing. Whole cities now are being downgraded from big cities to little cities because there are no people to live in them in Western Europe. The vitality is in the place of religion and family, and the secular world is collapsing and disappearing. Why? Why is it that Western culture is disappearing? Because Western culture had a great war between Catholics and Protestants. There were 30-year war, 100-year wars. Wars for generations to wipe out cities until the end was that Western Europe said enough with religion. Religion will not dominate society. Religion will go into church on Sunday and leave the government alone. Western Europe views religion as a mighty threat to physical survival. From that time on, about 500 years ago or 400 years ago, when Western Europe rejected religion's place in government and viewed it with great fear and trepidation, the secular world has been groping for a way to replace religion, and it created communism and revolution and different ideas. And whenever these ideas took root, they became religions. People were slaughtered, just like the religious slaughtered people, the communists slaughtered people. But one thing the secular world could not do is give people the drive to look beyond themselves, to make marriages and families and new generations of people. And therefore it is disappearing. But the secular world needed something to replace the creation story, and it came up with Darwin. Monkeys turned into people. Where are the missing links? There should be something in between monkeys and people out there. Or giraffes should turn into the next phase on a regular basis. We never see this. What's the thing underneath the giraffe? Whereas Dr. Gold, the famous evolutionist, said, the universe does not produce more complex life forms. It produces simple forms in great number and complex forms in very small number. He therefore said there is no natural process in nature to produce higher levels. It doesn't matter whether or not it makes sense or if it is scientific. The secular world had to have a substitute for creation, and he made it, Darwin. The Israeli election is about Jews who must choose between religion, the Jewish Torah, or the new secular type of whether he's a socialist or whether he's a capitalist, but he's a secular capitalist, or whether he is somebody interested in Judaism.